Hi, Paul with Diode Dynamics, and today we're going to be comparing LED fog lights. We released our SS3 LED pod a few months ago, and since then we've received a lot of requests for comparisons against other market options and against the factory halogen and LED options. So today we're going to show you some test data, do some measurements, and really see how all of these stack up. Now, when we say LED fog light, we're referring specifically to the J583 SAE standard for the fog light performance. And a big part of that is the beam pattern, which requires a sharp cutoff line and really wide distribution to light up the grounds right in front of the vehicle. All 10 of the lights we have here today meet that standard, so we'll be showing you the measurements and test results. Now, if you're here for just the results, go ahead and skip to the end. We've got all the info there. But we're gonna go ahead and walk through the options. Our measurements are gonna start in our light tunnel. At our facility in St. Louis, we have a long dark room with a goniometer on one end. That's a device that'll hold a lamp and then rotate very slowly back and forth, measuring each and every point in the entire beam pattern. If you wanna learn more about this, we have a whole video explaining how this test process works. But the result is an entire map of the full output pattern, which we can use to check the intensity at any given point. This gives us a great idea of the full beam pattern and how it looks, as well as the intensity. We've also run all these lights through our integrating sphere, which is a tool we use to look at the spectrum distribution, which determines the color of light, which we can report in degrees Kelvin. You might have heard 6000K cool light before, and we'll tell you what the color is of each of these lights here. The first light we're gonna look at is a generic H11 size fog light, which can be found on a lot of Subaru and Toyota vehicles. This is an aftermarket replacement. It's got a glass lens and it's based on the reflector there, and it's got a standard H11 halogen bulb. This is a very average performer. They're available for only about $30 a set. The output is 4,760 candela, shining in a 40 degree wide by 16 degree tall beam pattern. Like most halogen bulbs, this has a yellowish color output at 3100 Kelvin. So these are just going to provide baseline performance, but at $30 a set, you really can't go wrong if you just need a general fog light. The next lamp we're taking a look at is the Toyota Tacoma factory halogen lamp. This is also halogen, but it's quite a bit better in performance. This provides a maximum intensity of 5850 candela, a nice spread, 85 wide by 12 high. It's a 3100K light, and at just $50 a set, they're not too bad. Of course, you might already have these with a Tacoma from the factory. The next option is our first LED. This is a Koito option that's manufactured in Japan, and this ships as the LED option on the Toyota Tacoma. You can upgrade to these as well, and these provide an extremely wide beam pattern. With 5300 candela, it's a slight reduction from the halogen, but the beam pattern is 95 degrees wide, just an extremely wide spread of light. As you can see, it kind of ran off the edges of our test. It's only 5 degrees tall though, so it's a pretty short pattern. At 6300K, it'll match factory LEDs pretty well with a cool white color, and these can be had for just about $125 a set. So pretty good value for a factory LED option. The next one is our first complete aftermarket option. It's the MORIMOTO Type S fog light we have here in the white color temperature. The performance of this isn't too bad either. It's pretty similar to the factory LED output. It's a little bit lower in intensity with only 3700 candela, but it does have a 70 degree wide by 8 degree high beam pattern. It also has a 5800K color temperature, which is a little bit lower, but still generally cool white. At $205 for one set, this is a good option if you want that factory style appearance. Next up, we've got the KC Gravity G4 LED fog lights. This is the only LED we have here that's reflector based. As you can see, it uses reflectors. It provides 8500 candela peak intensity in a 70 degree wide by 10 degree high pattern. It also has a 4850 Kelvin color temperature, which is kind of a neutral white color, pretty interesting. And these come in at $300 a set. Might be a good option if you're looking for that reflector style. Next up, we've got the Baja Designs Squadron SAE. As you can see, this is a really nice compact package, and it might be a good option just based on the size. It's the smallest one we have up here. These shine with a 3500 peak intensity candela, which is certainly on the lower side, but it does have a pretty tall pattern. At 55 degrees wide by 14 degrees tall, it fills in the foreground really nicely. And with a 5100K color temperature output, it has that neutral white color as well, really a nice look. These are also right at $295 for a set. Next up, we've got the Rigid D-Series LED Cube here. And these have been on the market for some time, but they're still great performers. These shine with a peak intensity of 9300 candela, which is a great amount of output in a 60 by 9 degree pattern, in a really even pattern all the way from top to bottom. They have a 7900K color temperature, which is definitely on the cooler side, but might be the look that you're going for. At $295, they line up pretty well in terms of price point with the other options we've looked at. Next, we've got the Rigid 360 series. This is the newest option from Rigid, and it's got a really distinctive, nice look with some cool branding on the front as well. These are no slouch in performance either. Shining with 7500 peak candela, they've got a great amount of output in a 65 by 11 degree tall pattern. They do have kind of a split beam, which is interesting to see, but the total pattern is pretty tall because of that. They have a 6900K color temperature, your standard cool white, and they do come at a cost at $450 per set. Next, we've got our options that we produce here, which is the Diode Dynamics Stage Series. First, we've got the SS3 Sport. The SS3 Sport has a peak intensity of 10,600 candela with an 81 degree wide by 8 degree pattern. That's extremely wide with a huge amount of light output, and it shines in a 5900K color temperature, which is a great match for most factory LED lighting. These also come in at just $180 a pair. And as you can see, with most priced at about $300 a set, we feel these are great value, especially for that huge intensity number. Finally, the SS3 Pro. These look pretty similar, but the Pro is quite a bit different than the Sport. First, the intensity is higher. At 11,900 candela peak intensity, these are coming in just under the legal maximum for fog light applications. This is shining in a 90 degree wide by 12 degree pattern, just a huge amount of light in extremely wide spread. These are going to provide a 6900K color temperature, which is a little cooler than the Sport, still within that realm of the cool white modern color. The SS3 Pro comes in at $300 a set, which is more in line with the other aftermarket options we looked at. As you can see, there's a lot of options when it comes to LED fog lights. And whether you're going for something that's more of an off-road style or that factory OEM look, there's a lot of great options out there on the market today. It's our goal to provide raw data and just plain information to you so you can make the best decision possible. Whether you're looking for a higher intensity light or something lower, if you're looking for cool white or something a little bit warmer, we hope that this helps make your decision. You can find the Diode Dynamics SS3 series at diodynamics.com or through Diode Dynamics retailers. All the other lights I've gone over are available from standard online retailers like Amazon, eBay, that sort of thing. They're all great lights, well-built options, and we hope you'll find a great fog light for your application. Thanks for watching.